Talked about last week, the state of Florida is tripling down on their anti-transgender legislation. They've got three companion bills that would greatly expand legislation passed next year. For those who need a refresher, one of the bills would allow the state to modify child custody agreements if a parent supports their trans child in transitioning and classify providing gender-affirming care as child abuse. It would also, by the way, allow if your child is in a different state than you, if that other parent is transgender, or if the child is transgender, you in Florida can have the state take the kid from a different state, even though you don't have custody, and bring them back to you here in Florida. So basically legalizes kidnapping. It makes it a misdemeanor for a trans person to enter a bathroom that does not align with their sex assigned at birth. So that means even if you have had surgery, even if you have fully transitioned, you still would be required by law to use the bathroom of the gender you were assigned at birth. Otherwise, you're going to be criminally charged. And it would expand the state's controversial Don't Say Gay bill to include charter schools and prohibit instruction on gender identity and sexuality through the eighth grade. But an expert who has looked through the text of these bills, an expert by the name of Alejandra Caraballo, who is a clinical instructor at Harvard Law School's Cyber Law Clinic and former staff attorney at the Transgender Legal Defense and Education Fund, told Business Insider that some of these bills are basically using genocidal rhetoric to attack trans people. Here's what she said. I think that's important just to note how brazen the language has become. It's genocidal rhetoric. I mean, when you're talking about eradicating something like that, that's genocidal. For a long time, trans people have been called alarmist because we've been seeing this bubble up from the swamps of the internet, but it's becoming more and more vocal and it's being backed by legislation. And I think that's one other aspect to this, just how much of this is being driven by a pure drive to eliminate trans people from public life. And that's right. When you're talking about eliminating people from life, eradicating them, doing away with, this is genocidal rhetoric. I don't disagree with that statement at all. And the bigger issue is that we're passing legislation. And I have no doubt that all three of these bills will pass. Definitely the legalizing kidnapping one, that's totally not going to stand up in the courts. But they'll all pass. And why? Is this actually a problem? Are there actually children out there being forced to go through transitioning when they really don't want to? Are we just giving our kids puberty blockers down here in Florida or anywhere in the country, left and right, feeding them to them like they're Halloween candy? The answer to that, according to a Reuters investigation from 2021, is no. Fewer than 1,500 children across the country, according to that investigation, are even taking puberty blockers. Oh, well, what about the right-wing talkers who say that young women are getting their breasts cut off so they can become young men? There's fewer than 300 cases of that across the nation. So that's not an epidemic. Well, what about they're cutting off the genitals? There have been fewer than 56 bottom surgeries on children in the United States, according to that 2021 investigation. So the numbers don't back up any of this. The numbers don't back up the lies from the idiotic Republican talking heads. The numbers do not back up this legislation, yet they are still pushing the lies. They are still pushing the bills. They are trying to eradicate these people from public life because they're too stupid to know how to legislate on things that matter, right? They suck at the economy because they don't even understand how numbers work. They suck at the environment because they're too busy taking care of corporations, so they can't protect us, they can't protect our water, they can't protect our land, they can't protect our air. They suck at keeping us safe at work and letting us unionize, because again, they got to follow their corporate masters. So what do, since they can't do anything to actually help us? They throw red meat stupid talk to their base, tell them that transgender people are a plague upon this country, and they pass this legislation. Their base thinks they've done something good, when in reality, all you've done is further hurt people who are already suffering. But that's what Republicans are best at these days. Hey, thanks for watching. And if you want even more Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe. And don't forget, you can find me on all social media outlets at Farron Balanced.